take a tour through the Japanese gardens here at Hilo. This is some of the famous banyan trees. And as we stand here, we'll kind of give you a bird's eye view of where we're going to be going. Another mango tree that has a lot of fruit on it. And some of the bamboo, some of the statues. It rained very hard last night. The weather's about 85 degrees. It's very humid here. It's about 3:30 in the afternoon on Sunday. And Maxine and I are just enjoying a stroll. Very picturesque park, I think. Picturesque? That sounds a little better. Nice little stepping stones and walk areas. Continue our walk down towards the other end of the park.
horizon.
Kawaii chicken.
Wait a minute, I didn't get a still picture.
I think I didn't go. I don't know what I'm doing.
Just hold it.
Did you knock off the...
Coming into Koloa, and they're burning a sugar cane field here, getting ready to harvest it. This is the way it looks after it's harvested. Next they'll windrow it and take it by trucks down to McBride Plantation.
Better get this one.
Like at Ke Kaha, as a climber climbs a tree to bring down the coconut. Now we have dual duty here. Coconuts to smokestack at Ke Kaha Sugar. Here we are in Little Koloa Town with some of the prettiest colors of the tree. And this is what the neighborhood looks like. We ended Beach Boy looking over at the Coconut Marketplace. This is the way it looks between our units, and as we go out to the ocean, we can pick up the surf crashing gently upon the beach. And as we look down our beach area, seeing the people enjoying the surf. The ocean's a little rough out here today. Sleeping giant. And as we're doing the profile of the lifestyles of the rich and famous, this is where we stayed at the Kauai Beach Club. Looking at the swimming pool and the swimming area. And it's a beautiful day on the island of Kauai. And now we have a little closer look at that swimming pool, which is just a super area. Wailua River that takes you up to the Fern Garrotta, where they have very many weddings. There's a park area on this side.
You want us to wave?
This is the Dead End Gang from Kauai.
And you know, I hate to quit because we use the club so much, and
she gets
you know,
the club first.
Yeah, I get the club free, and you know, Rob uses an awful lot, and I have her in swim lessons twice. You know, and so it just really pays to
work.
Well, yeah, to just work a couple of days, so I still get the you know benefit of it. You know, because that's like, gosh, I think like
well,
60.
Melissa. Home run written all over it.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Al, I think you are.
Art's big pop-up, Mike.
Right here like that. I'll take that.
Casey at the bat.
What are you doing, Lindsay?
Yeah. Well, then I went back out.
Hi, Shelby.
I should have backed up all the way, you know, so nobody could even get. And, of course, he was.
Hi.
Throw him kisses, Shelby. Throw him kisses. Say happy Father's Day.
Saw the sharks like come out of the water. This is the way of the campsite.
Hey! Are you going to help Grandma?
Here, let me open this up.
Come and help Grandma open the presents.
You'll get more light if you... Yeah, go ahead and open that.
Lindsay.
More light. There you go.
Oh, that one makes so much.
And this is Lindsay. Our birthday girl.
Lindsay. Hey, Lindsay, well, come and help.
Can you do it? You should take that dress off.
Take your dress off, honey.
And Grandpa take a picture first.
You'll hear that later on in life.
Happy birthday. All the things you know. Are you listening, Lindsay? Grandma's off for rocking you and singing you to sleep. Grandma's off for giving you nice memories to keep. Ready of all, Grandma's off from love. Lindsay. And you got that open yet?
Oh, here, my grandma. There you go.
Happy birthday, Grandma. I just want you to know what a wonderful grandma you are to me. I'm so lucky. I'm so excited because my new brother or sister is going to... I thought you were. January.
17th.
17th.
I knew it all.
You're gonna have a winner, baby.
Well,
it slipped up.
Well, it's better than December.
Yeah. Sea cat's good.
Bang!
On an airplane, honey. In the flight.
Grandma's gonna be so lucky too. I can't. Only I didn't. Well, how far am I?
4 months.
I thought probably. I figured you. Well, at least when you went down on your anniversary thing.
Okay.
Lindsay, tell Grandpa and Grandma where the baby's at. Where's the baby?
Say right there.
Right here, huh? Yeah.
Doing that, it hurt. I know, just your baby, isn't that...
Yes, it is. Accurate?
Hi,
well,
Lindsay.
I mean, that there's
come
not
here.
That big a percent.
Well,
yeah. Look at him now.
Marcy, did you tell him anything yet?
Can you imagine?
You know, plus.
How cheap they went and used the same paper they went in on it.
Yeah.
ticket collection for wrapping paper.
I got to show you. I got two cards over there in Hawaii for over the hill and stuff. And Terry, I got to decide which I'm going to give him.
We got to go sit in the high chair.
Thank you. Yeah. No, I've got some that are kind of like, you know, I mean, they're as long as that. Yeah. Did you get the others down in?
What are they?
Earrings.
Oh.
Your patties.
Wait a minute.
Here, raise that.
Let me see your tongue again.
Where's your tongue?
Pregnancy of Vicki Lowe.
I don't know what you do if you have birthdays and anniversaries.
No. Here we are on our annual report. Wave at me. And what's your name, young lady? Hey, Mavis.
Right off the rest of the
look at it.
Show me.
You're on shaky.
Well, twice, actually. Steve has another job.
How come you're not talking to yourself again on this one? What's the deal?
Hey, you don't want to get wet, do you?
How come you're not talking to yourself?
Hi, Lindsay. Yeah, this is holding water.
Yeah, John Mavis is holding
water. Where's Carla?
Put that tongue in and give me a smile.
Is she? My wife's got a thigh mask. Is she?
Work out?
No, you're not. Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Day of our vacation. Spent the night here. Gorgeous area. And by golly, there's Big Blue. And of course, this is the best part's facilities. We're at the Oregon Trail Interpretive Center above Baker, Oregon. Area. give you a little look of the hillside here so you can see how gorgeous and green with the big trees. Oh, maybe it's a little dry and barren. And here we are at downtown Bergdorf.
Yes, sir.
This is one of the hot spring areas here in McCall, Idaho country.
The one right alongside the road, or the, where the road used to go, or us?
Not Medical Spring.
Yeah,
Medical Springs. I don't think so. There was one of them that was
not. We always stopped there, and then.
I'll take this, you must go. Got to go. Got to go.
Yeah. What are you doing?
Here. Here, Owen. Hold together, because it was, that is
hey, Ruth.
Country-made sausage.
Yes.
Sign the gate, shut your lips.
Don lady.
All right. Put it.
Yeah. Over on your...
There you go.
Yeah.
Hand off your hand.
Hey, smile, son.
From this angle. Thanks.
Wait a minute.
And it has to come.
All of you look this way.
That's right, all of you guys, get over here.
Well, he was supposed to get on this side.
We are amateur telephone.
Got to get the back door, XSP, I'm at a 5 mile on the face of human thing. Thank you. we really enjoyed it, and everybody laughed last year, said we wish we could have you back. Well, today was the Fayette River Cattlemen's Association picnic.
Be here. I did 4 years from my past. I didn't even get that long. Yeah. It's changed a lot because last time you guys were all over here and I was over there.
Yeah.
When I was a little kid, 3 or 4 years old, folks worked on a ranch and this is an experience that happened to me there. When I was just a little fella, about the age of 4 or 5, cowboys were my heroes. They were the greatest men alive. On up to Six Gun Packer, movie star, that's the cowboy most folks see, but the honest goodest buckaroo and making a living with the horse between his knees. Now my mom would fix her meals and I'd watch them while I was eating. When I tried to copy them, well, she threatened me with a beat. I could copy their cowboy way of walking, bow-legged, a little gimpy on 1 9-foot. And one time I tried some cowboy talking, but that soap made me sick and into bed last night. Come spring and grounding time, Dad told me I could go to the corrals that day, as long as I stayed behind the fire and didn't get in the way. Well, them cowboys is all that. Standing around waiting for the irons to get hot, and me, I just stand around too, happier than a hound licking the pie. And then they started cutting off chunks of something they was chewing, and I could smell something sugary sweet. Why, even candy's what they was doing. Now, I wanted some of that cowboy candy, but I didn't dare be asking, but they could see it on my face because my feelings I wasn't masking. Here, son, I have to chew, old Lynn Gessie says to me, and cuts and hands me a little sliver so my dad wasn't able to see. Well, I pops it quick like in my mouth and starts to chew like gum. Then I starts to worry some. Because it's getting hot. My tongue was burning off. I started heading for the pump I was gagging with every thought. Then the cowboys is all laughing at me. I don't know what to do. When I get big, I'll get eaten. I'll give some other little kid to chew. Pile it up and fill it full, that Copenhagen snooze. I went out to check the stock one cold and windy day. The horse I was riding was a half-broke little bay. I dug my can out of my pocket, but much to my surprise, I was about to fill my lip when it blew right in my eyes. I just dropped everything in my eyes. They burned and itched. I told Pony knew there was something wrong, so he swallowed his head and pitched. Well, I started to reach for something, tried to hold me on. It didn't do no good because I was laying on the ground. Well, I had supper, and it was getting kind of late. He was totally bare of facial hair, and on a cowboy, that's kind of strange. I reckon he was just about young to be riding on the range. He headed right up to the house, and I figured he was looking for work. And I hung around outside the barn and my curiosity was starting to perk. They came out and the boss saw me and hollered to come over. I went, I want you to meet our new hand. His name is Billy Fulmer. He claims to be the best there is and we certainly won't be sorry. He winked at me behind Billy's back. We'll just find out tomorrow. Well, I got him bedded down and then my shoulders kind of sagged. I kind of liked this kid. But he shouldn't have all bragged. You see, the boss was of the old school, and he lived by rules hard. You made your brags, you backed him up. So what if you got scarred? Bright and early the next morning, the boss roped him out of old Dolly. If he'd wanted me riding that horse, I would have quit by Dolly. You see, Dolly only did one thing well, and that horse could surely buck. When a cowboy climbed up on him, he'd just run out of luck. The kid pitched on his saddle and tightened up the cinch. He stepped forward and pulled the blind, and Dolly didn't move an inch. Then there came the blow up, and Dolly went in the air, and Billy was game and he could ride, and his spurs was pulling hair. He rode Dolly to a standstill and trotted out the gate. let's work those calves, he hollered. It's getting kind of late. Now, Billy couldn't grow no whiskers to cover up his hiding, but the boss and me both agreed that Jim could surely ride. He's the best I'd ever seen. And when the day was done, I let him know he was part of the crew. He was going to have some fun. We had us a bathhouse out back, and when the kid went in the shower, I'd find out if he could take a joke. And I did with starting to flower. Now I sneaked up to the door, even though I had no water. I jerked it open, pitched it in, a nice cold bucket of water. Then that takes off and running my mind all in the world. Best cowboy I ever seen turned out to be a girl. Okay. One more. You all had supper. You all ate your beans tonight. All right? Okay. My dad first came out here to this country in 1922, I believe it was, something like that. And, of course, like all young fellows, first thing you want to do is get a job being a cowboy. And he got a job on a ranch, and that's kind of how it went, I guess. We better eat them beans, boy, the cowboss said to me as I stared down at that tin plate balanced on my knee. Them beans will make you grow, son, he said with a toothless grin. Well, I might like them mushy things, too, if my teeth were used to it, man. And I started working better than a month ago for this feller called Tudor Bill. I was beginning to figure out how he got his names, because beans, I was getting my fill. I'd hired on this sorry outfit to help him gather cattle, but I was wearing holes in my underwear, and it wasn't from sitting in the saddle. I'd always wanted to be a cowboy, but I was losing some of my lust, because old Tudor tells me to be a cowboy, I gotta eat them beans for breakfast. I know bean eating is kind of a cowboy tradition, but I wish them old timers had only seen that it might have been a whole lot more thunder than lightning that was causing them Longhorns to stampede. Now, them beans might make you grow, and they might even fatten you like a hog. It's best to learn downwind, to ride downwind, unless you blame it on the dog.
Whitewater rafting on the Salmon River. Reagan, Idaho. That's what happens when you miss the rapids.
Too shallow and they cannot bring it in. So he had to dump the boat off and bring the trailer back and then walk out to the boat through the mucky water.
I wonder if you got pushed something for the voice. I never done the voice.
It's on when you're I would recording.
Oh, you're looking for my ratty ponytail.
was like walking out in there.
Yeah. Like behind the cow barn. So I guess we wear thongs. Yeah, but if
look
you wear,
Grandpa's doing
if
I
you
told
wear
him,
thongs,
it's too bad he didn't bring some old tennis shoes.
Yeah, because if you wear thongs, that just sticks.
Oh, you would lose look your there, thongs there right in the mud.
There they are.
What's he gonna do?
There they are.
There they are.
Yeah. Gonna go skiing. Can't believe the water's so smooth. There's nobody out there. Nobody's skiing.
Do, 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 do,
there
do.
They go. Bye bye. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
There they go.
Why didn't we just take off from here?
Over.
So I don't know.
There.
We haven't been up here so.
Daddy.
There's Grandma.
Wave hi to Grandma.
Say
there
good
kisses.
Morning, Grandma.
There
are
kisses.
She was wondering what kind of a.
You ought to see. We followed this. It was like a little Cherokee or Jeep or something. Anyway, this gal had this little girl. Looks like, oh, she's probably three maybe or so. Just running around the car. Coleman gal's hair that was driving. She'd get up, she'd get in front, sit by her, and just maul her practically. And I just, I just, you know.
Yeah, and then they wonder why
they're... I says, why don't you honk at her?
Why, really?
I mean, she was just running all over
and there.
And we were traveling.
Kids
there was close. There was quite a few cars, you know, close together and stuff. And, I mean, if she'd had to stop or something.
Ooh.
Just
scary.
Yeah.
I guess I stood
back. Oh, God. Hello, girls.
Lindsay.
How are you?
Kaya.
Lindsay Sandwich. Shelby Sandwich.
Shelby Sandwich.
Where's Lindsay?
She's tired. You tired, Lindsay?
Right.
See, right here. Right here.
Babies.
That's Shelby's. Say Shelby.
No.
You don't like to say Shelby?
No.
Say Grandpa. Hoods Park in Kennewick, Washington. This is the way that the camp looks. Masons and the Lowe's and the Crockers. And this is the Happy Hooligan and Gloomy Gus tribe. The twins. You say twins, Shelby. Hi. Yeah, twins. Hi, girls.
Not just playing there in it.
Run.
Look at this.
Now, we married the last year camping and
o'clock on Friday morning. This for glass. Good part. Kennewick, Washington. Friday morning. They'll come right up to you. Doing. Hold your hand out, Lindsay. This is the way that it looks from this side. Now they're all out there feeding the geese's. What are you doing, Lindsay? And we are sitting down to a 60th birthday.
Happy birthday, Billy Bob, Norman. You're going too fast.
Grandpa.
There.
Yeah, take
You're
it
going easy. Too fast. You're going to make people dizzy when they watch it back.
There you
need
go.
A shot of the carpet, too.
Dizzy.
Okay. Smile.
stripes.
Where's those velour things?
Yeah. Here, let me write the candles.
Write the candles?
Write the candles? Okay, you write them up.
Maybe you should left them.
What?
Ow!
You should have got him these kind of, when you blow them out, they won't blow off.
Hot.
Yeah. Hot.
Hot.
Right.
Wow. Hot. Fire.
Campfire. Hi, Shannon. Oh, I missed Chris over there. I don't think you can charge it on your car.
What are you doing back in there, Lindsay?
Good.
And
oh, yeah.
Here we are.
It
I'm
is
bright.
Looking good.
Hi, Shelby. Hey.
And there's Mr. Vern. Old 6 foot two.
That's me.
Looking at our camp and trail.
Oh.
Yeah, that's what we see from the campsite down here. And here we are on a beautiful sunny day at the old Paradise Lodge. Back over here. This is inside of the old lodge of Paradise. Snow gets 90 feet high here, and all you can see is the top of the chimneys in the wintertime.
He's a cinnamon bear. He's a light brown. That must be the one that's been down there, because they said he had a cub, she had a cub.
Oh,
and
really?
Yeah. Oh. Sometimes you come down here and there's so much water.
And here's the group coming up from the falls. Here comes a Sasquatch, Mount Rainier Sasquatch. Now that you've seen the falls from below, this is where it goes. And this is where we're headed. Thank you. the end of the Couch Glacier. It feeds into Squally River.
This is where she says you can go right out and not to go too far. I don't know how far it's to go.
This is Eagle Peak. It's right across from our campground in Cougar Run. Rainier coming down from the Couch Glacier.
Everybody wave.
Day number four at Rainier while it's sunshining. And here's the mini.
Same clothes. Different day.
Beautiful Mount Rainier. Squally River to the Couch Glacier, right on up to Camp Mir. Camp Mir is hidden right up there in the plain.
Oh yeah, that's a problem. That's a reason we couldn't see it.
Comet Falls. Here we are at the top of the waterfall.
Salads, mini taco salads, chef salads.
Oh, I didn't do that.
Tuna salad. Holly, are you getting any ones? They're ready.
Roll.
Hi.
Dave Lowe, do you? Dave Lowe?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Are you really? The waiter here?
Oh, no. Yeah. My brother.
Yeah, that's Lindsay.
Oh. That's Lindsay.
Oh, really?
You can.
Stand up so we can see.
Stand up.
My
name is
Mommy.
Yeah. Oh, it's pretty. And turn around.
Pretty.
You have peanut butter and jelly on your head.
Turn around for Grandpa. Oh. Turn around for Grandpa.
Turn around.
Grandpa. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to Lindsay.
What's this?
One of those toppings.
Strawberry toppings.
That's banana.
That's
what's your
food.
Okay. That's going to do it.
Hey, wait a second. What are you doing? Here's some more chips.
Lindsay, you like chocolate or strawberry better?
Strawberry.
Strawberry, that's what I thought.
Shelby.
Thank you.
I'll be right back.
Better watch your plate.
Bye-bye.
Did you eat up your hamburger?
Here we go.
So you guys get ready here to hit the road again?
Yeah.
How long are you going to be down there? A week?
As long as I can be down there. You're going to be golfing?
Yeah. You need a special license center, just a regular fishing license for those.
Trout license.
Trout.
Yeah, I don't think I can get her in trouble.
one down? Okay.
You sit on that. Do you want
to? You want these down?
Okay.
She just sits. You know, they've got down at Oregon Craft and Floral, they got paper for 10 feet for a dollar.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, what is it?
Oshkosh, bagosh.
Oh, man. Cool, dude.
Right.
Oshkosh, Wisconsin.
How pretty.
Oh, look at how pretty those are.
Oh, isn't that
okay,
nice?
On to the next item.
Perfect. Yeah. Isn't that
nice,
Mommy?
Shelby? You're right.
No.
You're right.
No.
Oh, what's that?
What is it in there?
Pull it out. Pull it out. What is that?
Oh, Lindsay, what is that?
Is
it a kitty?
What is
that?
Show Grandpa. Show Grandpa.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, is that a doggy?
Uh-oh.
Okay.
Lindsay, sit down.
Showing your belly?
Smell the flowers.
You mean the profile shot?
Smell the flowers. Turn around, show mommy your dog. Show mommy your dog. Wait a minute. Show her the smell of flowers right here. Just a minute.
No, that's fine. She doesn't want to
try. Look what Grandpa's got.
Stores going in over here.
Grandma, look at Grandma.
Lindsay. Lindsay.
Look at Grandma.
Grandpa.
Wait.
Yeah.
65 pounder either. And I have one. They set it up on 47 pounds.
Somewhere.
Kid of yours.
Scared of Billy's boy in the suit.